comics that we were reading, so we thought we'd do our own. We sat down and brainstormed a few ideas, and that's sort of thought about doing that. Had a few different names, Fat Farm, some other fat things, but Fatsville is what we decided on.
Fatsville is a dirty brown sneer on society's shiny, smiling face.
Fatsville puts the jelly in every woman's jelly hammock.
Fatsville is created so we don't have to actually go to jail. It's all safe in our own minds.
Fatsville is the land where my perverse, demented, unacceptable fantasies come to life.
Fatsville just is.
That's the best way to sum it up, isn't it, girls? Fatsville is Fatsville.
it's just different from the mainstream stuff, and I like to, it's nice to get into it, rather than, it's not squeaky clean, which is nice.
Pure comic anthology. I've only known his fans before. I like that song, it's really funny. Ben has got a really good style there. He's got this great classic sort of old style 50s, 20s sort of cartoon look.
This is not Disney. Disney would not feel comfortable producing this. This is non-corporate, that's why I like it.
And I like humour in my comics. I like more witty sort of stuff, and this looks like it has it in there.
I would have been interested to get into fan film, but I think what I do is slightly different to what they do. I have a different style of bum gang. Perhaps more eloquent, I don't know. Being an author, I suppose, I tend to word it up a bit more. And
I think in this day and age, to help promote more independent titles, I think we've got a great tool with the internet. So I think they need to be getting online, letting people know.
My name's Peter Reed. I'm a web developer. I'm currently working on a website. I created this page that you see here. Basically extending a bunch of their comics. We created sort of a festival collage of life as the background. So this is the first page you see when you come to the festival website. An animation created by Ben, one of the members. So basically the animation just plays through. World Wide Web is worldwide, it's international, so it shows up on the web. Anyone, anywhere in the world can get on there and see it.
It's like it was a good couple of months before that we were thinking about it,
yep.
Having meetings about it.
Yep.
If Supernova wasn't there, we wouldn't have been doing that. We probably wouldn't even have issue 6 out now.
Yeah, it has happened. We got heaps and heaps of exposure. We sold all our books, and so it definitely did work out for us.
We just sold out at Supernova, so we have to print some more. The shops are asking for them, which is pretty cool.
Like from Supernova, we met some guys that are basically doing the same thing we're doing with their thing, and they're keen to do exactly what we want to do, which is swap comics. We distribute theirs here, they distribute ours there, getting like a network sort of thing happening, so that's definitely going to go somewhere.
Have it all pulled together far better than before, and we'll probably put out a magazine to go with Festival as well.
Yeah, we're thinking about doing that. That's we can't really talk much about it now because it's under wraps, but we're thinking about bringing out a little sister magazine to Festival. Hopefully we want to try and get to Sydney Supernova as well next year, because they all know about us now, so it's pretty sweet. That was one of our goals out of it. So it's a good weekend though, there's heaps to look at, heaps to do. It was the best weekend for all had for a while.
You know,
without drugs anyway.